Good morning, children. I'm Mrs. Rashida, and today I'm going to teach you how to make a aquarium with all the recycled materials that you is available in your house. It could be magazine, it could be a piece of cardboard, whatever material you have, you have to use that and make an aquarium. Okay. So first thing that you have to take an A4 size paper. It could take an A4 size paper, and either you can use the paints if you have. If not, you can use your crayons. With the crayons and with your paints, first do the base. I'll teach you how to do the base. It's not required that you need to have a brush. If you don't have a brush, you can even use a piece of sponge or a cotton. Okay, and first you will use the white and the blue paints. And in case you don't have the blue and white, you can even use crayons. If you don't have the crayons, you can even use your color pencils. Only thing what you have to do is make sure that whatever side you are painting, make sure that you completely use the same side painting. Please don't change the directions. Keep painting. Okay, I have the paint, so since I want to complete it very fast, I will do it with the paints. You can do it with whatever the material you have. Okay, first thing that you need is to do the base. Keep doing, using whatever side you are painting, keep painting. If you don't have the paints and you don't have the crayons also, you can even use your watercolor pencils are available. If you have that, you can even use that. Okay, and keep painting. Continuously keep merging the color so that it gets blend with each other. Okay, in between, whenever you are using the paints, children, once you take the paint, the second time that you do is you use the water. Don't keep on taking the paint, because then the color becomes very dark, and we only want to show the color of the water. Okay, now this part of it I have already shown you with the brush. Now the rest of the part I will show you how to do it with the sponge. Okay, wet your sponge in the water. Take a little bit of, I'm changing the color just to give a very different color. So you just have to paint it with a brush or a cotton. Once you continuously start painting, you will get a nice smooth effect on your painting. It will dry quickly. You need not keep it to dry. Once it's painted, it looks something like this. Okay, now what you have to do is just leave it to dry. Till then, what all you can do is, if you have a piece of cardboard, just split it off from the two sides, and you can also, because we need the coral effect, we are just going to cut off these pieces from the front. And also either you can paint it, or you can again color with the crayons. Okay, whatever material is available with you can do it with that. Just first what you have to do is you have to paint all the materials and keep it ready. Then after that we can cut it and stick it together. Try to remove this so that with this effect you can have the rock effect, children. So it doesn't have to be removed totally. From here and there it can be removed. So this side, I will show you how to do it with the sponge also, in case you don't have the brush. Dip the and okay, and now if you want to give a bit of a combination, you can even add black into it. black and brown to give the coral effect. Okay, then you can cut any kind of fish you have with any color, kind of paper, either magazine paper or a newspaper, whatever you have at home, or a biscuit box, whatever you have, you can cut the, draw the fish and cut. I will show you how to make a fish. Okay, it's very easy, children. Now in this aquarium you can put all different kinds of fish. You can make an origami, you can do a you can do a thumb painting fish, you can draw and color and do it, or I mean you can just, but all what you have to do is you have to use only the craft material should be all recycled material. Okay, so whenever you want to draw something very equal, what you have to do is you have to draw the half side of it. Now you see, I've drawn the half side. Okay, I will cut it. When I cut it, I will get both the sides equal. Fold the paper. Always fold the paper and draw it so that both the sides will be equal. You see, your fish is ready. It's so easy. It's not such a difficult thing to do. You can, anybody can do it, children. It's very, very easy. Okay, and then we want to, you can use the magazine paper also, because in the magazine paper you get a lot of kind of vegetables and these things, so you can use that green color for the leaves, children. So you can just remove the places where there is these fruits and vegetables and take the green part, so you can use them for your seaweeds. You can use them for your seaweeds. See, the entire aquarium will be made only with the recycled material. No other material will be used. So everything which is available in the house, you can do your picture. You can even use the yellow color. You can use the mangoes. Okay, all you can use different colors. Then you can make little fish with this. You can fold it again and draw a little small fish. See, so different kinds of fish you can draw and do it. Now I'll show you how to complete the picture. Okay, this paper of yours has already dried. Okay, and how does it look? It looks something like this. Now we'll cut it. It doesn't have any shape and sizes. You can just cut any shape you want. It doesn't have to be equal size. Just whatever way you want to cut, you can cut it. Okay, but every piece can be used. Remember, the one side of it has to be straight and the others have to be in different shapes. You can use your glue. You can use any kind of glue. You can use UHU glue. Whatever the glue you have at home, you can use that. Very cool. Everybody, I think when you got your books, along with your books, you would have got a glue also. So you can use that. excess part, you can cut it off if you don't require them. So one part of the aquarium is been done. Now we are going to do the second part. Okay, the seaweeds. It doesn't have any shapes and sizes. Now here you can even do the thumb painting, children. Okay, you can do it in different colors. So we are going to use all the different things. We are going to do with origami, then we are going to use the thumb painting, all different kinds of fish we are going to use here. Okay, I'm sure your teacher has already taught you how to make the origami fish, so you might be knowing how to use do the origami fish. You just need a square paper. You need a square paper. Okay. You fold it into like a handkerchief, like a fold, and then you push it outside from the either sides. Okay, I think it's almost done in all the classes, so all the children already know how to make the fish. And do the right and the left. Make sure that you do it after it's dried, if not your markers will get spoiled. So you have to make a small aquarium using the recycled materials. Okay, all the time it's not required that you need to buy. Everything can be done with reused materials, children. And we should try always to make sure that, you know, we maximum try to use whatever is available at home. Try to make your picture with whatever you have at home. Can you see this? Okay, you can make more fish. You can cut any kinds of different fish. You can cut a starfish, whatever you want to do, you can do. You whatever kind, it doesn't have. Only thing that when you are drawing, you need to use this kind of techniques. Draw only a half fish so that you can it's very easy and very beautifully easy to be done, and it's very, very interesting, children. Very, very interesting. You can go on and on and on. It really relaxes your mind. And it looks nice and colorful. can make any different kinds of fish you want. See, when you open it, you get the nice fish with equal size. So here you have completed your fish. Whatever you have, at if you have pearls, you can use. You can put these. I have these tamarind seeds. I can use those. You can use pista shells. You can use corals. Whatever you have, you can use all different kinds of things. You can use, children. Whatever you have at home. Try to use all the recycled material available at home. So you have, how many things do you have here? See, what kind of things do you have here? See, you have a magazine paper. Okay, you have a piece of biscuit box. You have finger and thumb painting. You have cardboard. You have magazine, and your picture is completed. It's eco-friendly. We are not using anything. Nothing to be bought, and it's zero expense. And look at the picture, it's so beautiful, children. Okay, hope you all liked it. If you liked my video, please like, subscribe, share, and comment. Please don't forget to comment so that I would add more ideas into my drawings.